Good morning friends, this is Professor Kadir Sheikh from MIT Aurangabad. Today we will see the development of one hexagonal pyramid. Now I am reading the question. Question number 2. So a hexagonal pyramid with base side 30 mm, height 60 mm, raised on HP, one of its side parallel to VP. This is cut by a section plane as shown in the figure. So draw the TLS of the remaining portion of the pyramid. So to draw the hexagon, first draw one circle, mark two endpoints as A and D, then take the radius equals to the radius of the circle and keep your compass on A dash and draw one arc to cut at the top and at the bottom with the same radius with center as D. Draw two more radius, so you will get six corners of the hexagonal pyramid. Now join all these six corners by the straight lines, so these will be the sides of the hexagonal pyramid. Now join this all six corners with the base, so that we will get the slant heights in the top view for the hexagonal base pyramid. Now draw the XY line in the project the apex O dash in the front view. Similarly, project A dash as a front view of A, then B dash F dash as front view of B and F, C dash E dash as front view of C and E, and D dash. Now we will get all six corners here in the front view. Now measure the height on the D axis and join all these base corners with the apex, so that you will get the front view of hexagonal pyramid. Now to draw the cut section as shown in the problem, so draw one semicircle with center here, middle of this triangle, and radius equals to 30 mm. Then measure 30 mm from the XY line and draw one projector to cut the A dash at this point, and through this point draw one 30 degree line, so that you will get the second cut section. Now we will highlight the cut portion. So this much cut portion we have to develop now. Now to start the development, first we know that any one slant height is either showing true length or not. So we know that O dash to D dash is parallel in the top view. So OD is parallel to XY in the top view, means it is parallel to VP, means it is going to show true length in the front view. So O dash D dash is already a front view. So in this case, we need not to find out the true length of the slant height. Now with O dash as a center and up to D dash as a radius, draw an arc. After drawing this arc, now measure the side of the hexagon, and it shows true length in the top view. So measure this much height and cut with this much radius in compass 6 times to this arc, so that you will get the 6 corners A, B, C, D, E, F, and last point is again the same as the starting point A. Now join all these corners with the apex O dash, so that we will get 6 triangles. So this 6 triangles shows the DLS of the hexagonal pyramid. Now we will locate the cut section. So to start with the cut section, first we will see the cut section of this 30 degree line. Now all this 30 degree cutting plane, it cut all the 6 slant heights of the pentagonal pyramid. So you will get 6 cutting points. So we will locate the cutting points starting from P dash. So P dash lies on O dash, A dash. So after that Q dash, it lies on B dash, F dash. R dash lies on A dash, O dash. And S dash lies on D dash, O dash. Similarly, some backside cutting points will be there at E dash, O dash. So it will be same as R dash. Backside cutting for F dash, O dash, it will be same as Q dash. Now we got the six cutting points. Now we'll project them one by one. First project P dash on the true length. Now O dash as a center up to this much as a radius, draw one more arc. So this is the arc for the cutting point P dash. Now as cutting point is on O to A, so in the DLS also it should lies on O to A. So OA is here, same as O dash D dash, and the same line you can treat as OA. So cutting point P dash will be somewhere here. So P dash is here. After that, project Q dash on true length. Now with O dash as a center and up to this much as a radius, draw one more arc. Now Q dash lies on B dash, O dash and F dash, O dash. So mark them on B dash, O dash and F dash, O dash. So Q dash should be two times, front side on B and back side on F slant heights. So we have marked them here. After that, project R dash on the true length with O dash as a center, draw one more arc. Now R dash lies on CO and EO, so mark them on CO and EO. So we have marked R dash on CO here and EO here. After that, project S dash as it is already on true length, so draw a radius with O dash as a center, draw one more arc. Now S dash lies on D dash O dash, so it should cut D O here in the DLS S dash. Now join all these cutting point by a straight line, you will get the DLS of the 30 degree cut line. Now this will be the exercise for you people. Now decide the cutting points for this semicircle. So roughly let me decide as cutting points as this cutting point, let me say L1, and this is L2. So L2 cuts in between E and D, L1 cuts in between B and A, similarly F and A. So two cutting points here, two cutting points here, then two cutting points at this point, two cutting points at this point. So you'll get 2 plus 2, and one more you can add here, so that you can get the extreme top position of the point on the semicircle. So 2 L1, 2 at point B, 2 at the extreme height, 2 at C, and 2 in between E and D. So 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2, so you'll get 8 cutting points for the semicircle. Now what you have to do, you have to project all these cutting points again on the true length, follow the same procedure, draw the arc as this cutting point is on this in between B and C. So take middle of B and C, draw this arc, so you'll get one cutting point here. Okay. Similarly, one more cutting point is in between F and E, so take middle of that, draw it and continue this arc, you'll get cutting points. So like in the similar fashion, you continue for all the remaining cutting points and draw the DLS. So this DLS will start between this B and it will continue like this. So draw this DLS, and this is the homework for you people. Thank you for your patience listening and watching.